Is it new program tomorrow?
You can't play by ear.
And what? Fuck. Okay. What's one of the variables that drives hypertrophy? Different movement pattern, maybe. Different angle. What do you guys do if you program every 3 weeks? Exactly. Like, I mean, I don't know how big your fucking PT toolkit is. My mind ain't that big. There ain't that many exercises on the planet. Like, you're using, you know, and again, it comes back to us wanting really to impress her when you write your program, picks up your program. Oh, I've seen Tyler's program, it's hectic, it does all this sort of stuff. Yeah, cool. Is it getting tons of muscles? Is it getting maximal hypertrophy? Well, let's learn this stuff and say, oh, well, actually, yeah, I'm programmed for a decent length of time. I'm starting, you know, minimum effective, then I'm going to adaptable, then I overreach them here, then I deload here. We've got 6 weeks to add load over time. Yeah, it's a pretty good hypertrophy program. My volume is this. I start at, you know, 20 sets and I go to 25 for adaptable. I take it to 30 for 1 week, then I drop back down to 15. Yeah, it's ticking boxes for hypertrophy. So that would impress me. It looked boring. I was like, oh, it's like six exercises. Is that it? Yeah, well, guess what? I got a fucking ton of exercises to use in my next program. Because the whole issue is, I think, you can write a killer program. You can write a fucking, man, yeah, programs are hectic, but write it for 2 years. Yeah, we want to have longevity with our programming. And when we stick to these parameters, when it's hypertrophy specifically, we know what to manipulate. We know what to change. We know in what, okay, now general population, exception to the rule, there's got to be a little bit of excitement, a little bit of strength maybe. So that, okay, influence, go back to what you know about undulating periodization. Maybe